Hi, I'm Kinkas and I'm a synth DIY guy. Welcome to your channel for music and sound design with modular synthesizers, synth DIY, and new technologies. And today, we're going to have a look at the new Black LPG from Erica Synths. This is a Vactrol-based low-pass gate with a few tweaks. It's actually a second-order low-pass filter, whereas the original Buchla was a first-order voltage-controlled filter. A low-pass gate is, of course, a VCA filter combination used in West Coast synthesis for amplitude control. And this one has a mode switch where you can choose between VCA operation, VCF operation, and both. And one of the very interesting features it has is a mode CV. So you can actually externally control these modes with a voltage that you can plug in here. There's a CV input for the offset, and there's even a built-in decay envelope generator with its trigger input, a decay CV, so you can control the decay externally as well, and you even have a dedicated envelope generator output so they can drive something else with the same envelope. There's a resonance control that goes all the way to self-oscillation, and there's a drive circuit that you can switch on and off in that resonance, right? So let's have a listen. I've plugged in a saw wave from my Black VCO2 here to the input. And right now we're listening to the both setting, but let's go to filter first, right? No resonance drive, resonance all the way low. It just sounds like a nice filter. Let's hear it with a lower note. And start bringing the resonance up. You get a more noticeable sweep, right? And if I turn that drive on, then it gets pretty gnarly. I'd say you'd get even into acid territory this way. Let's hear that with a pulse wave. More resonance. Resonance drive. All right, let's bring that back down. Let's listen to it as a VCA. As a VCA, it preserves much more of the high end, but it still has an effect on the timbre as well as the volume, which is really interesting. And in fact, is how acoustic instruments work as well. When you play something louder, it's usually brighter. And here's the both setting, where it's both a VCA and a filter. Turn on that R drive, more resonance. All right, let's leave it in this both setting here and turn on a sequence. Let me just clear the sequence here on our Black sequencer. It's making a cameo on this video. Stay tuned, I'm making a complete video manual for the Erica Synths Black sequencer. That's coming soon. So let's press play and have a kick drum here on the drum sequencer. And we can quickly set up a sequence here. So I'm using the internal envelope generator, right? Which can go from very, very snappy like that. To pretty long. And yeah, with the resonance drive and the resonance high, this does sound pretty acidy. Let's dial that back a bit. Okay, I have the modulation output from the Black sequencer channel 1 connected to the decay CV. So let's program some decay variation, shall we? Nice, right? Make it shorter. All very cool. This is the bolt setting. Let's put it in VCA. Cool. And that's the pulse wave. Let's hear a triangle there. And a saw again. Here's both, and here's filter, VCF response. Nice bass. This is, of course, the manual control. And as you can tell, it also controls the depth of the decay, the built-in decay envelope. I want to use an external envelope generator. It's as easy as just plugging the trigger into that output into the CV. Right. I can use a random voltage here, clocked random voltage. Make it a little faster. Now let's go back to the internal. Now we have the internal envelope generator running alongside the sample and hold. Or actually, we can use this mixer here to attenuate it and bring it back in, but more subtle. Take the output here into the CV. There you go. It's a better balance of the random sampling hold with the built-in envelope generator with that decay CV varying right there. Now I can use the modulation output from channel 2 here of my sequencer. You can play a little bit with the mode CV control. And we'll program that in. Maybe put it in both. Well, this is kind of hard to read, so let's connect that mode CV to just a voltage source here that I can control. It's the Journalog Select 2. Put that in the mode CV in there. Cool. So I have it in the middle here, right? I'm sending it negative 5 volts now, and it's a VCA. As I start turning the knob, it's a little off camera here, but you can hear it. This is the bolt setting in zero right there. And I keep going till it's positive. And we get that VCF response. So it's actually continuous. So if I use an LFO, for example, let's get a triangle LFO going here. Up that resonance and we'll really hear more of a difference, I think. Very cool. That's an interesting new way to introduce tonal variation, timbral variation. Right? Let's go back to using the black sequencer's modulation output too. Very cool. Let me change these notes a little bit. that tired of these notes. There you go. I'm gonna go with the VCF. This is super nice. Let's turn off that kick. You can just hear this super cool bass. If we use a more complex sort of sound source, right? Well, we can hear noise. As a VCA for that noise. Both. And a filter. And now let's use the output of the Black VCO expander. The expander lets me add in like a sub, mix the saw, modulate that saw a little bit, and the pulse width of the pulse wave, add that in too. So now we have a little bit more complex wave. Yeah, that's pretty nasty. Love it. Let's get that kick back in there. That resonance drive is just insane. KCV back going. Love that. That could be random too, actually. Let's randomize that. Use that sample and hold output again. Nice. It's improvising. Nice. Very cool. VCA. Switch to triangle here. Maybe we'll leave the pulse and saw down. Use more of the triangle. Very nice. Less resonance. Let's mute that kick again. Nice. This combination is amazing, actually. The Black VCO with the expander and the LPG and the Black sequencer. Jeez. The raw Rolls Royce of 303s, I think. I send audio rate modulation to the CV input. So let's take a triangle wave from another oscillator here. I've got the Ericsynth bass line. Triangle out into CV input here. Sequencer here would be fun too. Let's turn off the decay envelope. That sounds pretty cool. That's it for today. There's not much more I can think of to show off this amazing module. It's the coolest low-pass gate I've ever had. And I'm loving it. You're listening to my main analog voice these days. This combo right here. So if you like the video, remember to hit like, subscribe, possibly join my Patreon. Stay tuned for upcoming videos, a lot of them in the works, including the full video manual for the Ericsynth Black Sequencer right here. So that's it. See you soon. Stay noisy.